वेलकम बैक टू द डिस्कशन ऑन रेगुलेशन ऑफ जीन एक्सप्रेशन इन प्रोकैरियोट्स। सो वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द एमसीक्यूज ऑन लैक ऑपेरॉन कॉन्सेप्ट। लेट अस हैव अ डिस्कशन ऑन अनदर क्वेश्चन विच इज डिस्प्लेइंग ऑन द स्क्रीन। मेरोज़ाइगोट रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम रिकॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू इकोलाई लैक म्यूटेंट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड हाफ मैक्सिमल लेवल ऑफ बीटा गैलेक्टोसिडेज विदाउट द इंड्यूसर एंड मैक्सिमल लेवल ऑफ बीटा गैलेक्टोसिडेज विद द इंड्यूसर। द जीनोटाइप ऑफ द मेरोज़ाइगोट इज मेरोज़ाइगोट मीन्स द पार्शियल डिप्लॉइड्स। सो हियर द जीनोटाइपी आर शोन। सो इन दिस केस द ऑप्शंस दैट आर गिवन आर ओ प्लस आई माइनस जेड माइनस on one DNA molecule and on another DNA molecule, that is on maybe on bacterial chromosome. The operator is wild, repressor gene is also wild, and lac Z gene is also wild. So in this case, the maximum level of expression will not be seen. The second option that is given is OC mutation, I plus and Z minus mutation on one DNA molecule, whereas on another DNA molecule, that is on bacterial chromosome, the operator, lac repressor and beta galactosidase gene all are wild. So in this case also the maximum level of beta galactosidase expression will not occur. In this case the OC mutation is there, the lac repressor is mutated one, and on the another DNA molecule the operator, repressor gene and beta galactosidase gene all are wild. So in this case the maximum level of expression will occur. The reason is that in B and D the OC mutation is there, but on the same DNA molecule lac Z gene is having mutation, and so it will be non-functional. So it will result in inducible expression from the another DNA molecule, whereas in C when lactose is absent a particular level of beta galactosidase expression will be seen, but when lactose is present the repressor bound to the operator will be removed, and so an increased level of expression or maximal level of expression of beta galactosidase will be seen in this case. So the correct option is C. Here is another question. While studying the lac operon in bacteria, a scientist isolates mutants of E. coli which always express the genes of the lac operon constitutive synthesis. The scientist creates partial diploids of the regulatory elements of the lac operon in these mutants of E. coli. In one partial diploid, expression of the lac genes is observed even in the absence of an inducer. A likely explanation for this result is which of the following? Number one, there is a mutation in cis with the operon. There is a mutation in trans with the operon. Inducer can no longer bind to the repressor, and D, inducer binds too tightly to the repressor. So if we look at this, the constitutive expression will occur when the operon, the operator is not recognized by the repressor, and generally such OC mutations are cis in nature. Second option B, that is there is a mutation in trans with the operon, this cannot be correct one. The inducer can no longer bind to the repressor, this also is not possible because it will not result in constitutive synthesis, because the repressor is active but it is mutated in such a manner that inducer is not able to bind to the repressor. So induction will not occur even in presence of inducer. Inducer binds too tightly to the repressor. Now here in this case this also will not result in constitutive synthesis because the repressor is able to bind to the operator. So the correct option among these is there is a mutation in cis with the operon. Another question. Four mutant strains of E. coli having the following characteristics were isolated. Strain 1, lac repressor is not able to bind to operator because of a mutation in the operator region of the lac operon. Strain 2, in this, allolactose is not able to bind to repressor because of a mutation in the repressor encoding gene. Strain 3, catabolite activator protein is not able to bind to the promoter because of a mutation in the promoter region. And strain 4, cyclic EMP is not able to bind to catabolite activator protein because of a mutation in the catabolite activator protein encoding gene. Lac genes are expressed in which of these strains? So if we look at all these strains characters, only in the strain 1, lac repressor is not able to bind to the operator, and because of a mutation in the operator region of the lac operon, so here in this case the expression of lac genes will occur. Whereas in other cases, allolactose is not able to bind to the repressor, that means the repressor cannot be removed, and so here lac genes will not be expressed. Catabolite activator protein is not able to bind to the promoter, so here the catabolite activator protein will not result in positive regulation, so here also in strain 3 lac genes will not be expressed. Cyclic AMP is not able to bind to the catabolite activator protein, so here cyclic AMP CRP complex will not able to form, and so the expression in such mutants of the lac genes will not occur. So the correct option is the strain 1 will result in expression of lac genes. Another question, a strain of E. coli has the following genotype with respect to the lac operon: I minus, O plus, Z plus, Y minus, and A plus. So here the repressor gene is mutated, because of which it is not able to bind to the operator. Whereas other genes, if we look at lac Z is functional, but the beta galactoside permease is non-functional. So even if lactose is present in the medium, it will not be transported inside the cell. So let us have a look at the option. The strain will produce permease only in the presence of lactose. This is not correct. Will not produce beta galactosidase if lactose is present in the medium. This is also not correct. The beta galactosidase will be produced, but will not produce permease irrespective of the presence or absence of lactose in the medium. This is correct because the Y gene, lac Y gene, which encodes for beta galactoside permease, is mutated, so it will be non-functional, and so a functional permease will not be synthesized. And the fourth option, the strain will produce transacetylase only when induced. No, this is also not correct. So the correct option is C. The strain will not produce permease irrespective of the presence or absence of lactose in the medium. So now we'll have a look at another operon model, that is TRP operon. In this operon, the genes which are needed for the biosynthesis of tryptophan, or the genes which encode for the enzymes that are involved in the biosynthesis of tryptophan, they are clustered together and are transcribed through a single promoter. So this TRP operon is an example of a repressible operon. And another mechanism of regulation of gene expression in case of TRP operon is also seen, which is attenuational control. Now this TRP operon is under negative regulation by a repressor protein, that is TRPR. TRPR encodes for the TRP repressor protein, which is active in presence of tryptophan. So when tryptophan is present, the TRP genes need not be expressed. So to have a negative control, the repressor binds to the operator of the TRP operon and exerts a negative control. But that is not enough. In case of prokaryotes, transcription and translation both can occur simultaneously. So when the transcription has initiated, when RNA polymerase has gained access to the promoter, the transcription has been initiated, and once the 5' end of the mRNA is available, ribosomes will get loaded onto the mRNA. Before the transcription is completed, translation can begin. So simultaneous transcription and translation is possible in case of prokaryotes. So to have a second level of regulation, the attenuational control is seen in case of TRP operon, in which there is a synthesis of leader peptide, which is encoded by the leader sequence. This leader peptide contains few codons for TRP. So here is the figure of TRP operon, in which the 5 genes TRPE, TRPD, TRPC, TRPB and TRPA. These 5 genes are clustered together and are transcribed through a single promoter. There is one leader sequence, or there is a region encoding the leader peptide, which ensures the presence of the TRP charged tRNA molecules inside the cell. So by several genes, they are expressed once the leader peptide is synthesized. So having a leader peptide will give advantage to the cell for monitoring the tRNA molecules charged with particular kind of amino acids. So here the leader sequence will monitor the TRP levels inside the cell. So and another gene which encodes for the TRP repressor is shown, located near the TRP operon. It is transcribed through its own promoter. So when TRPR is expressed, TRPR mRNA is translated into protein, and the dimer form of the TRP repressor bound by the tryptophan will be active, and this TRP bound TRPR protein occupies the operator site and exerts a negative control. So when tryptophan is present in the medium, the TRP repressor will exert a negative control. To ensure that the RNA polymerase, which has gained access through the promoter before the TRP repressor has bound, the transcription process must not continue, and for this an attenuational control is exerted, where the leader sequence, the mRNA region which encodes for the leader peptide, plays an important role in deciding the fate of the transcription process. Now here is the leader sequence in the TRP mRNA shown over here. This leader sequence can be divided into 4 regions: region 1, region 2, region 3 and region 4. This is of about 160 nucleotides long. Now region 1 and 2 are complementary, but they never pair. Region 2 and 3 are complementary. Region 3 is also complementary with region 4. So 2:3 base pairing and 3:4 pairing will decide the fate of the transcription process. Now here is the figure which is showing 2 cases. When tryptophan levels are high, what will happen? When tryptophan levels are high, many tRNA molecules charged with tryptophan will be present, and so The lac mRNA which has been synthesized will be subject to translation on the ribosome, and the ribosome will immediately synthesize the will immediately start synthesizing the leader peptide. Now in the leader peptide there are two codons for, here you can see in the leader peptide there are two codons for tryptophan in the region 1. So these will be immediately incorporated in the leader peptide which is being synthesized on ribosome, and the ribosome will immediately enter into region 2 for translation when tryptophan levels are high. So by that time sequence number 3 and 4 are available, and so they can pair up. So when tryptophan levels are high, the ribosome immediately enters into the region 2 by incorporating the tryptophan in the growing leader peptide, and this results in formation of 3:4 pairing. 3:4 pair structure is an attenuated structure, and when such kind of pairing occurs, it results in premature termination of the transcription process. Because of hairpin-like structure formation, the RNA polymerase experiences jerk, and so the RNA molecule is removed. The RNA polymerase is also removed from the template strand, and the termination of the transcription process occurs. This is referred as attenuational control. What will happen if the TRP levels are low? When the TRP levels are low, there are less number of TRP charged tRNA molecules in the cell. And so, when the leader sequence is available for translation, ribosomes get loaded onto the TRP mRNA and start translating the TRP mRNA, first resulting in formation of leader peptide. Now in this, the region 1, when it is encountered at the position, when the ribosome encounters the TRP codons in the leader 1 region, as the TRP charged tRNA molecules are low, the ribosome will pause for a while at these positions, and so this gives time for sequence 2 and 3 to pair up with each other. When sequence 2 and 3 pair up with each other, sequence number 3 will not be available to pair with region 4 or sequence 4, and so the attenuated structure will not form. And as the attenuated structure is not formed, the continued transcription will occur by the RNA polymerase. So when the tryptophan levels are low, genes encoding the enzyme for biosynthesis of tryptophan are needed, and so the TRP mRNA must be synthesized continuously. So here 2:3 pairing will not result in attenuated structure formation, and so continued transcription will occur. So this kind of regulatory control is seen in case of TRP operon. So if we look at the regulatory control in TRP operon, it is subject to repressible or that is negative control by TRP repressor, and in addition to that, it is also subject to attenuational control. Another example is that of ERA operon. Here in this operon, the genes whose products are involved in the metabolism of arabinose sugar are clustered together. Now ERA operon is an example of an operon in which same regulatory protein acts as a repressor and an activator for regulating expression of ERA genes. It is under negative and positive control by ERAC protein. So ERAC protein is the regulatory one which exerts positive as well as negative control under different situation. So in this figure, the ERA operon is shown, where this is the ERA O1 site, ERA O3 site, ERA I site is shown. ERA I site is the site at which the protein in active form, which when it is present as an inducer, it will occupy the ERA I site. Now here the genes encoding the enzymes that are involved in the metabolism of the arabino sugar are clustered together, ERA B, ERA A and ERA D. So ERA B encodes for ribulose kinase, ERA A encodes for arabinose isomerase, and ERA D encodes for ribulose 5-phosphate epimerase. So when arabinose is present in the medium, it is transported inside the cell by permease system, and the arabinose is isomerized to ribulose by the action of arabinose isomerase, which is then phosphorylated by ribulose kinase, resulting in formation of ribulose 5-phosphate. This ribulose 5-phosphate is converted into xylulose 5-phosphate, xylulose 5-phosphate, which enters into pentose phosphate pathway. So this is how arabinose is metabolized when ARABAD genes are expressed. Here in this figure, ARAC is shown, ARAC gene, which is transcribed through its own promoter. It is a regulatory gene, and you can see one operator site is present within the ARAC gene. We'll have a discussion on this later on. ARAC gene, when it is transcribed, the ARAC mRNA is translated, resulting in formation of ARAC protein. Now this protein, in absence of arabinose, is repressor. The same protein, when it is bound by a signal molecule, is active as activator. So here the signal molecule is arabinose sugar. When arabinose is present in the medium, arabinose binds to the ARAC protein, which is the repressor one, and converts it into an inducer or activator. So depending on the situation, whether arabinose is present in the medium or absent, there will be a different role of this ARAC protein. One site is also shown over here, catabolite activator binding site, protein binding site, CAP site. So here cyclic AMP CRP complex also will bind, but the induction will occur only when ARAC protein in form of an activator occupies the ARA I site. Then and then only the expression of ARA bad genes can occur. So let us have a look how the ARA operon is regulated. We'll discuss this one by one situation. ARAC expression. Here the ARAC protein, which is a regulatory protein, it is transcribed through its own promoter, ARA promoter C. So here, using this promoter, the ARAC protein, ARAC gene is transcribed, which is then translated, and when the whether the arabinose is present or absent, it will have a different role. ARA bad genes, they are transcribed through a single promoter, that is promoter bad, whereas ARA I site is there, which is occupied by the ARA C protein in activator form. Now you can see here there are two sites within this ARA I region, I1 and I2. Both should be occupied by the ARAC protein in activator form. So this figure indicates what will happen in presence of glucose and absence of arabinose. When glucose is present, cyclic AMP levels are low, and so what will happen, cyclic AMP CRP complex will not form, and as cyclic AMP CRP complex is not formed, the cyclic AMP CRP complex will not be able to bind to the CAP site, that is catabolite activator protein binding site. Also, as arabinose is absent, ARAC protein will work as a repressor. It will have a different configuration in which the ARA-C protein will be active as a repressor. So in absence of arabinose, the ARA-C protein occupies the O2 site and half I1 site, which will exert a negative control on the expression of ARA-BAT genes or ARA operon. So when arabinose is absent, the negative control is exerted by ARA-C protein. Now this figure shows what will happen if glucose is absent and arabinose is present. When arabinose is present and glucose is absent, glucose is absent, cyclic AMP levels are high. Cyclic AMP will combine with catabolite activator protein forming cyclic AMP CAP complex or cyclic AMP CRP complex. This complex binds to the CAP site. Also, as arabinose is present, arabinose binds to the ARA-C site and makes a conformational change in the ARA-C structure. Because of this, the ARA-C protein is not able to occupy the O2 site. And so what will happen? The ARA-C protein bound to arabinose now functions as a activator molecule. This molecule has occupied both the half I sites, I1 and I2 in the ARA-I region, and exerts a positive control on the expression of ARA-BAT genes. So the same repressor, same protein, regulatory protein, is exerting a negative control when arabinose is absent. When arabinose is present, the ARA-C protein exerts a positive control. So this is a quite different case in which the genes expression are regulated by a single regulatory protein, ARA-C protein. So let us have a discussion on few MCQs related to TRP operon and ARA operon. The question that is displaying on your screen is: the tryptophan operon is under negative control. It is on in presence of low levels of tryptophan and off in the presence of excess tryptophan. The symbols A, B and C represent the genes of for tryptophan synthetase, the operator region and the repressor, but not necessarily in that order. From the following data, in which superscripts denote wild type or defective, determine which letter is the gene for tryptophan synthetase, the repressor and the operator. The plus and minus signs are shown over here in the table. Plus is tryptophan synthetase activity, that is activity is showing, and negative minus sign indicates there is no tryptophan synthetase activity. So here in strain 1, the genotype is shown A minus, B plus and C plus. In this case, when tryptophan is absent, the tryptophan synthetase activity is shown. In absence of tryptophan also, the tryptophan synthetase activity is seen. In strain 2, now you can see that whenever the B plus is there, okay, the tryptophan synthetase activity is seen in present or absence of tryptophan. Here the myrodiploids are shown in strain 4 to 7. So in this case also, the tryptophan synthetase activity is seen. At least one B plus is there. So in this case, you can see that at least one B plus will result in functional tryptophan synthetase. And if B minus is there, that is if the mutation is there in the B gene, then it will not result in expression of tryptophan synthetase. So we can say that the B is tryptophan synthetase, and likewise the A is operator and C is repressor. So among all these options, the first option is the correct one. Another question: which of the following statements concerning the TRP operon leader RNA, which has 162 nucleotides preceding the initiation codon of the first structural gene of the operon, are correct? Number 1, a deletion mutation in the DNA encoding the 3' region of the leader RNA gives rise to increased levels of the biosynthetic enzymes forming TRP. This is correct. A short ORF, that is open reading frame, containing TRP codons, among others, exist within the leader RNA. This is also correct. The leader RNA encodes a test peptide whose ability to be synthesized monitors the level of TRP tRNA in the cell. That is, it monitors the levels of TRP charged tRNA in the cell. Yes, so this statement is also correct. The leader RNA may form two alternative and mutually exclusive secondary structures. That is, one attenuated structure and one is 2:3 pairing. So these are mutually exclusive secondary structures which are formed within the leader RNA region. So this statement is also correct. The structure of the leader RNA in vivo depends on the position of the ribosomes translating it. So this statement is also correct. So according to me, all these statements are correct. So if you look at the options 1, 2, 3 and 5, the another option is 2, 3 and 4, third option is 1, 4 and 5, and the correct option is D, in which all these statements are shown to be correct. Now in the coming questions, we'll have a common explanation on which the question number 16 and 17 are designed. Besides the repression or de-repression control of TRP operon, the second level of regulation is known as attenuation. The presence of two TRP codons within the TRPL controls this phenomenon. The presence of tryptophan charged tRNA TRP causes the premature termination of transcription, yields a 140 nucleotide long leader sequence transcript. Now, by site-directed mutagenesis, the two UGG codons which encode for TRP, two UGG TRP codons of the TRPL sequence were modified to CGG which encode for arginine. Which of the following amino acids would be able to restore the attenuational control of TRP operon? Tryptophan alone, arginine alone, tryptophan or arginine, neither arginine nor tryptophan. Now here we can see that by site-directed mutagenesis, arginine, the TRP codons are replaced by arginine codon, and so the attenuational control can be restored by arginine alone. So option B is correct. Deletion of part of the TRPL region will result in, number 1, increase in the rate of expression of TRP structural genes, B, decrease in the rate of expression of TRP structural genes, no change in the rate of expression of TRP structural genes, or D, inhibition of the expression of all the genes in the operon. Now here, if the TRPL region, that is the region which encodes for the leader peptide, if that is deleted, then the rate of expression will increase. So option 1 or option A, that is increase in the rate of expression of TRP structural genes, is the correct one. Another question. Tryptophan operon in E. coli is an example of number 1 inducible operon, next positively regulated operon, repressible operon, all of the above. It is not positively regulated one, and so the correct option is C, that is tryptophan operon in E. coli is an example of repressible operon. Next question, which one of the following statements about the TRP operon is true? The RNA product of the TRP operon is very stable, that is not correct. The TRP repressor is a product of the TRP operon. No, this the gene encoding the TRP repressor is not part of the TRP operon. So this statement is also incorrect. The TRP repressor, like the LAC repressor, is a tetramer of identical subunit. No, TRP repressor functions in form of a dimer. So this statement is also incorrect. Next option, the TRP repressor binds to tryptophan. So out of these, the last option, that is the TRP repressor binds to tryptophan, is correct. So the correct answer is D. True statements about the bacterial TRP operon include which of the following? So four statements are given. The TRP operon has two kinds of regulation, one by an operator and another by an attenuator. This is correct. The repressor complexes with the co-repressor and on binding to the operator blocks transcription. So here tryptophan amino acid can be regarded as co-repressor, which binds to the repressor protein and activates it. So this is a correct one. When tryptophan is in short supply, the leader sequence containing the attenuator cannot be accessed and stalled, and the stalled ribosome modifies the mRNA so that the structural genes are transcribed. So this statement is also correct. Fourth statement, the co-repressor is the catabolite activator protein. So the catabolite activator protein is not acting as a co-repressor. So the statement S is incorrect. So out of these PQRS statements, the PQR statements are correct. So the correct option is C. Next question. A mutant of E. coli was isolated which synthesized greater than normal level of tryptophan synthesizing enzymes in the absence of tryptophan. It was found to make normal TRP repressor and also had normal TRP operator. Which of the following mutations might result in the observed phenotype? Option A, deletion in the TRP promoter. This will not result in such case. Deletion just after the promoter operator region. Now deletion in the promoter in the region just next to the promoter operator region, that region is for leader sequence. So if the leader sequence region is deleted, then it will result in increased expression of TRP genes. So this is correct. C, deletion just before the coding sequences for the TRP enzymes. So this may also involve the promoter region. So if the promoter region is deleted, it will not result in expression of the TRP genes, because promoter is needed for the expression of the genes. So this statement cannot be correct. D, deletion in the road independent transcription termination signal. So this will not apply over here. So the correct option is B, deletion just after the promoter operator region will result in enhanced expression of the TRP genes. Last question, which of the following is true for ARA operon? It is subject to attenuational control by arabinose. No, attenuational control is not seen in ARA operon regulation. It is regulated by two separate regulatory proteins exerting positive and negative regulation. If we remember, ARA operon is under regulation by a single regulatory protein. So this option says that there are two separate regulatory proteins governing the regulation of ARA operon. So this statement cannot be correct. Number C, it is regulated by a single regulatory protein which exerts both positive and negative control. So this statement is correct. ARA C protein is the regulatory protein which exerts positive and negative control on the expression of ARA genes. So the correct option is C. So friends, we have discussed quite few details on the operon concept, covering the lac operon, TRP operon and ARA operon. So I hope this will help you in the preparation for competitive exams. So if you have queries, you can send the queries on this email ID. All the best. Thank you.